lesson on the graph of the cotangent function. The goals of the video are to determine the graph of cotangent and also to determine the key properties of the cotangent graph. So since cotangent and tangent are reciprocal functions, if we draw a tangent line to a point on the y-axis rather than the x-axis, we can form a cotangent segment here in red. And the length of this segment is equal to cotangent theta. And notice that this is angle theta here in standard position. This is also angle theta. So in a similar fashion to our tangent segment, we can use similar triangles to show that cotangent theta is equal to t, this being the cotangent segment. Remember that when we have an angle in standard position, cotangent theta would be equal to x over y. So we want to show that t is equal to x over y. Well, because these two triangles are similar due to angle-angle similarity, we can set up a proportion using the corresponding sides such that x over y is equal to t over 1. And since they're similar triangles and this is a proportion, cross products must be equal. So we can multiply x times 1 to get x and t times y to get ty. Then to solve for t, we can divide both sides by y, and we have now shown that t is equal to x over y. So the cotangent segment is equal to the ratio of x over y. Let's go ahead and look at a Wolfram demonstration to illustrate this. So again, in red, we have the cotangent segment. So at an angle of 0 radians or 0 degrees, the cotangent segment has an infinite length, and therefore there's going to be a vertical asymptote at 0 degrees or 0 radians. Notice as we approach 90 degrees or pi over 2 radians, we have very long cotangent segments graphed here on the coordinate plane, but as the angle approaches pi over 2 radians, it's shrinking, and at pi over 2 it will have length 0, as we see here. So here's one piece of the cotangent function. Then as we progress toward pi radians, again the segments are very short, but because this segment is left of the y-axis, we're giving it a negative value. And as we approach pi radians, it's getting longer and longer in the negative direction. And again, you can see it's approaching negative infinity. So again, at pi, we have a vertical asymptote. As we continue around the unit circle, again, you can see the cotangent segment in red. It's approaching 0 as we approach 3 pi over 2 radians. And then as we approach 2 pi radians, it's negative, approaching negative infinity. And so from one revolution around the unit circle, we've actually completed two complete cycles of the cotangent function, and we can see the period would be pi radians. So to graph this by hand, we're actually going to use the fact that cotangent and tangent are reciprocal functions to produce the graph. So we'll assume we can graph the tangent function, and from that, we'll graph the cotangent function by taking reciprocal values of tangent theta. So in gray, we have tangent theta already graphed for us. So we're going to pick some key values on the tangent function, find the reciprocal values, and plot those for cotangent. And we'll start off by figuring out that where tangent is equal to 0, the reciprocal of 0 would be undefined. So the result would be vertical asymptotes at 0, pi, and 2 pi. Next, we know the reciprocal of 1 is 1. Reciprocal of negative 1 is still negative 1. And reciprocal of as well as to the right. Next, for the same reason why when tangent is 0, cotangent is undefined, where tangent is undefined, or there's a vertical asymptote, cotangent would be 0. And let's pick a few more key values. Where tangent is equal to 0.5 or 1/2, cotangent would be 2. Here, here, and here. So we've already have these vertical asymptotes here, and we have these four points here. Let's go ahead and try to find a couple more key values. Here, where tangent theta is equal to negative 1/2, reciprocal of negative 1/2 is negative 2. Here and here. And lastly, let's say this is where tangent is equal to 1/4. Reciprocal of 1/4 would be 4. And here, where we'll approximate the value of negative 1/4, the reciprocal would be negative 4. And very quickly, we can see we have a nice graph of y equals cotangent theta. And since the period of cotangent theta is equal to pi radians, we'll have a similar graph between these two vertical asymptotes, and so on. Now, of course, if this was hard to follow, you can always pull up your graphing calculator and find function values that way. So my calculator's in degree mode, and for y1 I typed 1 over tangent x, since there's no cotangent key. And then just to compare, in y2 I entered tangent x. So y1 will be our cotangent function, and y2 will be the tangent function. So I'm going to go ahead and press second graph, and again notice that at 0 degrees, there's an error for cotangent, meaning there's a vertical asymptote. Tangent was 0. Again, at 15 degrees, we have approximately 4, or somewhere in here. At 45 degrees, pi over 4 radians, we're at 1. Now notice the calculator does have a problem at 90 degrees, or pi over 2 radians, because we're using the tangent function to evaluate this. And since at 90 degrees, tangent is undefined, the calculator cannot evaluate this for cotangent theta. So it is important that we recognize the relationship between the graph of tangent theta and cotangent theta. But again, this can be helpful for most values of cotangent theta. And let's go ahead and take a look at the graph on the calculator. Again, I'm in degrees, so I'm going to enter in a window that's appropriate for degrees. So let's say negative 45, 405, x scale will go by 30 degree increments. And then y minimum, let's go to negative 5 to 5 by 1s, and we'll press graph. And there's the graph of our cotangent function. It's also going to graph the tangent function now, as we see here. Okay, let's summarize the key components of the graph of y equals cotangent theta. So the domain would be any angle such that theta is not equal to a multiple of pi radians. And again, that's because that's where we have our vertical asymptotes. The range would be from negative infinity to positive infinity. The x-intercepts occur at odd multiples of pi over 2. So 1 pi over 2, 3 pi over 2, and so on. The function has vertical asymptotes. The period is pi radians. There is no amplitude. And the graph is symmetrical with respect to the origin, and therefore is an odd function. Okay, I hope you found this overview helpful. Thank you and have a good day.